we can revise the lesson. This is lesson number two. Last spring. So last spring, and you can also see an image of a child, right? There's something we can say that last spring, last childhood. The stories of stolen childhood. You know what is the meaning stolen? That means, you know, totally destroyed. We can say that destroyed. Destroyed means erika alikapattadun solu. So stories, legend, stories of stolen childhood of particular children. We can take from a part. We can go for a slum. We can go for a village, a remote area. We can take likewise last spring. So here the topic represents last spring means spring, springtime, spring season. That means spring of a child, spring of children, childhood, childhood or not, childhood experience. Childhood is known as spring. That's why it is known as last. You know what is the meaning last? Thridapattad, alikapattad, odukapattad, anything you can say. So about the author, Anish Jang, 1964, was born in Rourkela and spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. And she received her education in Hyderabad and in the United States of America. And her parents were both writers. Anish Jang began her career as a writer in India. She has been an editor and a columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad. And has authored several books. The following is an excerpt from her book titled Last Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. So here only two experiences, only two episodes we are going to have that. One is related to Sai Vialam and second one is Mukesh. That's our two experiences, right? We are going to have that. So you can see that. The following is an excerpt from her book titled Last Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Here she analyzes the grinding poverty. That is very important. You know what is the meaning grinding poverty? Grinding means totally destroying here. Here the meaning, we can consider grinding poverty, destroying poverty and traditions which condemns these children to a life of exploitation. So you know what is the meaning? Exploitation means utilization, abusing the children totally. All evilish nature. You know what is the meaning? Evilish nature. Or we can go for devilish natures, right? Notice this expression in the text. Notice this expression in the text, infer the meaning from the context, looking for and slog their daylight hearts, roof over their head, perpetual state of poverty. That is playing a vital role. You know, perpetual means everlasting state of poverty. You know, what is the meaning poverty? Or we can say that scarcity of everything. Scarcity of everything, poverty or poverty stricken. Poverty stricken means the poverty line, below the poverty line. So perpetual means everlasting, never ending state of poverty. Dark hatmans, put a second one, imposed to the baggage on the child. That means, you know, everything, the family's responsibilities are everything, baggage, right? Imposed the baggage. They're taking that weight, responsibilities on the shoulders of the children. Those who are from slum, the particular things, particular area, what we are going to discuss. So sometimes I find it would be the lesson divided into two part, two experience. One is known as sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage, and second one is I want to drive a car. So you have two things. First one, sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. So it is easy to understand, right? Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. So garbage. And if we find rupees, or we can take rupee, or we can take some things in the garbage means, so we can identify that. It is like, you know, maybe the street dwellers, like we can consider. So those who are rag pickers in the sense, kuppai porukki avangala valkaya vali nadathuru. That's why street dwellers also we can say, theruvulla vasikkar, street dwellers. We can take that. So here her experience, narrator Anish Jang started. So here, sometimes I find a rupee. I is the protagonist of this episode. Protagonist, you know what is the meaning? Main hero, Sai Bealam. Sai Bealam, Sahib E-A-L-E-M, Alam. Sai Bealam, you have to pronounce Sai Bealam. It means Lord of the Universe. That means Lord of the Universe, like Kodisparan or like Chalipadi. Right, anything we can take. Harichandran, but he is always lying, taking that, you know, some name related names. Karana Perdal, there is a reason behind the name. So here, why do you do this? I ask whom I encounter every morning, scouting for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. So here the narrator came forward and of course started her narration, like, you know, what she had. And she went and of course she had these two kinds of experiences. That's why she wanted to share with the readers of 12th standard. So why do you do this? We will also ask, you know, while looking at Baker's, we will ask that, why do you do this? Will we or not? We will also ask, why do we, sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, super. Subhanadi has come. Good, 17. Exactly. Super, super. For the revision. Right now you can see. So why do you ask this, or why do you do this? Why do you do this means it's a very simple present question. Why do this? I ask this, are you whom I encounter? Encounter in the sense meet. So meeting every morning, and of course whenever she met, and he was scrounging. You know what is the meaning? Scrounging means looking out. That means searching, digging out. You know what is the meaning? Digging out means don't eat it. So morning scrounging for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. So wherever she saw that, and of course she came to see that, and they were scrounging. Especially the protagonist, we are taking that Sahib. Sahib Alam, right? And she asks, Sahib left his home long ago and said amidst the green fields of Dhaka, and his home is not even a distant memory. There were many storms that swept away their fields and homes, his mother tells him, and that's why they left and looking for gold in the big city where he now lives. By taking that, you can also underline the word. I already told you the Dhaka capital of Bangladesh, and this is what, you know, taken place. So here, Sahib left his home long ago. So before, you know, having experience about the protagonist, small introduction by the narrator. So here, Sahib left his home due to too many reasons. And of course, we can take poverty stricken, we can take some influence, some impact. So Sahib left his home long ago, set amidst the green fields of Dhaka, and his home is not even a distant memory, and there were many storms in the sense, we can take maybe obstacles, struggles, storm, underline the word, problems or barriers, and of course swept, totally cleaned away their fields and homes, his mother tells him. So wherever they lived, and of course where they lived, and they just shifted, and of course migrated their original place, that means native place, to some other place, and this is the reason. And his mother tells him. And that's why they left. And of course, left their native place and they shifted somewhere. And of course, Himavari named, right? And of course, they settled. And they started their living. And of course, that was the native life it became. And of course, here, looking for gold in the big city where he now lives. Started his business, rag picking, right? Rag picking, he started his business. So I have nothing else to do. He mutters, looking away. He was having a very casual looking, you know, that's why looking away. And of course, he mutters in the sense, the way a rag picker, or we can go for a baker. Right? We are saying, we nowadays we have been seen, you know, we have been seeing like too many children. It means, you know, those who are street dwellers, and of course, those who are bakers, their children, they are also homeless, and of course, they are aimless, and of course, protectionless. Like, they are also. Even in the childhood also, they started baking, and of course, living in the street, and of course, they are also digging too many things and getting things from the garbage. By that, they are living. So that's likewise the way those children will look. He has also. So I have nothing else to do. He mutters, looking away. Go to school, I say glibly. So here, glibly in the sense, you know, that means easily, simply, I say, simply, you can insert the word glibly and write, simply, go to school, I say, simply, realizing immediately how hollow the act advice must sound. Simply, we will, you know, advise. So instead, you can also go and do this one, that one. Anyhow, so nowadays, you know, too many engineers are jobless. While looking at them, we can simply say that, hey, you have completed engineering, then you can also go and get a job. You can search, find out a job, and you can work just for, you know, 8,000 and 9,000. Yeah, completed 4 years. And of course, they spend 5 lakhs and 6 lakhs for their engineering course, UG undergraduate. But for a job, they have to get only 8,000, 9,000. How is it possible? Simply, we can say that. But they have the real pain. So here, likewise, go to school, I say simply, and then realizing immediately how hollow means empty, without, you know, understanding their situation, condition, the advice must sound for them. Whatever, you know, that it's like, you know, if blown all pieces, then you are it a piece, they really likewise, you know, we cannot go and explain too many things to them. they're all, you know, it's like given up students, given up, abandoned, கைவிடப்பட்டவர்கள். அவங்ககிட்ட போயிட்டு நீங்கள் வந்து யூ ஹவ் டு நோ லைக் யூ ஹவ் டு பிஹேவ் லைக் இன் திஸ் வே தட் வே அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் யூ ஹவ் டு கோ யூ ஹவ் டு ஜாயின் இன் அ ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் என்எல்சி அண்ட் தெர் இஸ் நோ ஸ்கூல் இன் மை நெபர்ஹுட் வென் தே பில்ட் ஒன் ஐ வில் கோ வெரி வெரி சிம்பிளி ஹி வாஸ் ஆல்சோ வெரி கேஷுவல் ஸோ தட் கேஷுவலி ரிப்ளை தெர் இஸ் நோ ஸ்கூல் இன் மை நெபர்ஹுட் வென் தே பில்ட் ஒன் ஐ வில் கோ இஃப் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் அ ஸ்கூல் சி ஆஸ் இஃப் ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் ஸ்கூல் வில் யூ கம் வில் யூ கம் அண்ட் ஜாயின் ஐ ஆஸ் ஹாஃப் ஜோக்கிங் Yes, he says simply, smiling broadly. He was also willing. Of course, he was also having that interest, but not a chance he received. That's why. So here you can see that there is no school in my neighborhood. When they build one, I will go and join. Then simply the narrator asked, if I start a school, right, will you come and join? I asked, half joking. Now sometimes, you know, we will also say like that. Yes, he says, smiling broadly. That means he was interested in joining in the school, but he was unable to do that. Since he was a rag picker. So a few days later, I see him. So it's like a day's roll experience. A day's roll experience means 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, 8 days. Like a few days later, I see him running up to me. When I met him, he ran and of course. So I see him running up to me and ask, is your school ready? Because he was innocent, right? He was innocent and of course he was a child. We can take that. He was a boy, and of course, he was innocent and ignorant. So simply he came and asked the narrator, is a school ready? Is your school ready? Yeah, he asked. It takes longer to build a school. I say embarrassed, something in it, having made a promise that was not meant. But promises like mine abound in every corner of his bleak world. So something, you know, that times he realized, the narrator realized that, and because that was like having made a promise that was not meant. Simply, you know, just I as half joking, you know, that's the fun, but he just took it very seriously because he was innocent and ignorant. That's why. So it takes longer to build a school, I say, and of course embarrassed in the sense, you know, felt uneasy because she thought of, you know, making fun, but he was taking very seriously. That's why she meant that, and of course. And but promise, and she was also realizing that, but promises like mine, like me, many of them have come to their place and of course reached their place, visited their place, and of course like politicians, we can take government officials, we can take, they have visited always for getting the votes, for getting the support, but everything is like an empty promise. So but promises like mine bounce, underline the word, you know, full of, but means full of in every corner at us. Bleak world, you know, have a close bracket. Bleak world means very dark world, joyless world. So joyless. So when your parents are bringing everything, when your parents are providing everything, you will be happy, right? Your world will be joyful world, right? Joy and lake you can also enjoy. So whatever you want that is given to your hands, even in your hands, means you will be very happy. Think of them, those who are, you know, bent down and of course given up. Nothing can be, you know, even the proper dress code, proper silk, munavu, urai, sabhyati, udai, urai vidam. Three things are there, right? Munavu, udai, and of course, urai vidam in thumb. That means, you know, your dress, and of course, your, you know, meals, then your shelter. Three things are very important. Three things are less, and of course, that's fine. So, but promises like mine abound in every corner of this bleak world. She thought, so after months of knowing him, they became very familiar and of course friends. So I asked him his name and he mentioned Sahib Alam. So he has Sahib E. Alam, Sahib Alam. He announces, he shares, and of course he does not know what it means. What it means or means, if he knew it mean, its meaning, Lord of the Universe. So it is very important. Sahib Alam and of course Lord of the Universe. You can underline and make an important symbol for your objective. Lord of the Universe, what does it mean? What does it mean? Or it refers to the protagonist, Sahib Alam. Right? And who's the author of the lesson? Anishan. What is the name of the lesson? Last Spring. Not the Last Spring. Last Spring simply. The Last Lesson, Last Spring. And he would have a hard time believing it when he comes to know that. That means that's why he mentioned that. Whenever Arokya Swami or Kodishwaran or Lakshadipadi or Arichandra, too many names, we are also giving that, right? He does not know what it means. If he knew, when he comes to know, if he knew its meaning, Lord of the universe, he would have a hard time believing it. So he will laugh, and of course laugh at himself. So another of what his name represents, he roams the streets with his friends and army, an army of barefoot boys. You know what does it mean? Army of barefoot boys, in the sense, once we had, you know, in the, even in the, especially in the village, in the villages, children would do like that, of course, barefoot. And of course, they had a team with the team members. They went somewhere in their fools, you know, they used to do that. And of course, even take bath in a well, and of course, even a river they visit, and some forest areas, and hunting something, likewise, you know, set of boys. Likewise, here he roams the street with his friends and army of barefoot boys who appears like the morning birds, only morning, in the morning, and of course disappear at noon because of the hot sun. And over the months, I have come to recognize each one of them. So each of them meets one by one. Saibe elements, I have next friend, next friend, like Raja, Mukesh, Saravana, likewise you can see. So why are you wearing chappals? I asked one. So it is something because of curiosity. And because of curiosity, while looking at them, we will also sometimes ask, why aren't you wearing chappals? Why does he like? We can take that particular when we are taking them. So it's plurals, he asked the plural. So why aren't you? Why aren't or not you wearing chappals? I asked. My mother did not bring them down from the cell. This is the, he answers simply. That means one of the boys answers simply, my mother did not bring them down from the shelf, right? Even if she did also, he will throw them up, because adds another who's wearing shoes that do not match. That means, you know, they were not affordable. They were not affordable, or they cannot afford, they cannot purchase. When then, of course, someone wore, and of course, you know, adds another who was wearing shoes that did not match, in the sense, alternative, something else. One shoe, one part he got from someone, and of course, another part he got from someone, like pieces we can take. So adds another who was wearing shoes that do not match. When I comment on it, he suffers. That means, you know, why you are wearing a different pair of shoes, like, then he just suffers and adjusts himself, feet, and says nothing. No, he didn't speak anything because he felt shy. I want shoes, says the third boy. So here we're taking Shoaib Alam, then first boy, second boy, third boy, like one by one, so around four members. I want shoes, says the third boy, right, who has never owned a pair of parolas. Like, so traveling across the country, I have seen children walking barefoot in cities, on villages roads, not only in cities but also in villages. It is not lack of money. That is also one reason. It is not only lack of money but also a tradition to stay barefoot is another explanation. Two things, right? First one is money. That means, you know, that means their affordable life, sophisticated life, they are lacking in that, because since they were from rag picking community, we are taking based on their even job and profession. It is not lack of money, but she was telling that it is not only, but also. So it is not lack of money, but a tradition to stay barefoot means they feel uneasy, right? So is one explanation. I wonder if this is only an excuse to explain away a perpetual state of poverty. This means, you know, that means my mother did not bring them down from the shelf. This is what she mentioned, right? And of course, if this is only an excuse to explain away a perpetual state of poverty, right? You can underline that. I wonder if this is only an excuse. You know, what is the meaning? Pretending. Excuse means pretending or acting or managing to explain. And of course, makeup, do making up. Like, so make up a perpetual, underline that, have a close bracket, but perpetual state of poverty means, refers to, and this is from last spring. Like, you can go far, you know, first one, sometimes I find a rupee in the car, which are I want to drive a car. You have to choose the best, most appropriate, right? You can choose. And perpetual state of poverty means everlasting, long lasting, never ending. That means, you know, poverty stricken. Perpetual means முடிவே இல்லாத ஏழ்மையில் வாழக்கூடிய மக்கள், அதனால தான் அவங்க எல்லாம் ஸ்ட்ரீட் வெல்லர்ஸா இருக்காங்க, தெருவுல வசிக்கிறவர்கள். So I remember a story, a man, and here the narrator comes to, you know, give a story. That means story within a story. I remember a story of a man from Udupi once told me, as a young boy, he would go to school past an old temple. That means, you know, crossing an old temple where his father was a priest. He would stop briefly whenever he was crossing there, briefly at the temple, and pray for a pair of shoes. 30 years later, it's years old experience. I told you, days old experience, like here, years old experience. That means now one generation to third generation. First generation, whatever they pray, whatever they did, requested the Almighty, I think in the second generation completed, the third generation will be received. Likewise, 30 years later, I visited a town and the temple, which was now drowned. Drowned means totally desolated. You know what is the meaning? Desolated means submerged. That means, you know, changed. A lot of changes, which was now drowned in an air of desolation in the backyard. That means in the courtyard, we can take, that means in the play temple yard, where lived the new priest. That means 30 years old experience. There were red and white plastic chairs. That means somewhat sophisticated. Young boy dressed in a gray uniform, school uniform, wearing socks and shoes, arriving panting. That means crying or shouting, and of course weeping. We're taking that as something new. So he came and threw his school bag on the folding bed, and of course folded, right, folding bed, looking at the boy. So he whatever they did prayer, whatever he prayed. So the third generation, like 30 years later, those were, and of course they got that. So looking at the boy, I remember the prayer another boy had made to the goddesses when he had finally got a pair of shoes. That means like generation-wise. உங்களோட தாத்தா ஆசைப்பட்டிருப்பார், இப்ப நீங்க படிச்சுட்டு இருப்பீங்க, நீங்க ஆசைப்படுவீங்க, லைக்வைஸ் யுவர் ஃபியூச்சர் ஜெனரேஷன். சோ லெட் மீ நெவர் லூஸ் தெம், ரைட். அண்ட் ஹியர் த நரேட்டர் இஸ் திங்கிங், ஆஃப் கோர்ஸ் த காடஸ் ஹேட் கிராண்டட் அஸ் பிரேயர், அண்ட் ஆஃப் கோர்ஸ் த யங் பாய்ஸ் லைக் த சன் ஆஃப் த ப்ரீஸ்ட் நவ் வர்ஷோஸ் 30 இயர்ஸ் லேட்டர், பட் யங் பாய்ஸ் லைக் த சன் ஆஃப் த ப்ரீஸ்ட் நவ் வர்ஷோஸ், பட் மெனி அதர் லைக், மீன்ஸ் ஜென்ரேஷன் வைஸ் ஜென்ரேஷன், பட் மெனி அதர்ஸ் லைக் த ராக்டிகஸ் இன் மை நெய்பர்ஹுட் ரிமைன்ஸ் யூஸ்லெஸ். மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள், நாட் ஒன்லி மென்ஷனிங் த ஷூஸ் பட் ஆல்சோ தேர் பெர்பெச்சுவல் ஸ்டேட் ஆஃப் பாவர்ட்டி. மீன்ஸ் இன் எவ்ரி கார்னர் ஆஃப் தேர் லைஃப், அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட், எவ்ரி கார்னர் ஆஃப் தஸ் லைஃப் கேன் டேக் எவ்ரி நோக் அண்ட் கார்னர் ஆஃப் தேர் லைஃப் வி கேன் கன்சிடர் தே ஆர் இன் அ பெர்பெச்சுவல் ஸ்டேட் ஆஃப் பாவர்ட்டி. That means no sophisticated life, no full-fledged life, no happy life. But many other like the ragpickers in my neighborhood continued. My acquaintance means relationship with the barefoot ragpickers leads me to Simhapuri, a place on the periphery of Delhi. So Delhi, Bangladesh, then of course they migrated from Bangladesh and settled in periphery of Delhi known as Simhapuri. Yes, it was taking place, that story, right? So here, periphery means, underline the word, outskirt. Outskirt means, that means we consider it. So it's apart, away from main city. A place on the periphery of Delhi, yet miles away from it. And of course, metaphorically means, you can take their life as has nothing. That is known as the met. That means, maybe symbolically, we can take symbolically, they are away from a good life. Those who live here are squatters, underline the word. Squatters means already told you, that means refugees, like, are those who settled down illegally. Those who settled down illegally, who came from Bangladesh back in 1970. So 1971, they migrated from Dhaka to Delhi. And Sahib's family is among them. And of course, Simhapuri was then a wilderness, underline the word. What is the meaning? Sorry, wilderness, I told you. That means can underline the wild means maybe then a wasteland. Then a waste, W-A-S-T-E. Wasteland means no sophistication, right? No sophistication, not for cultivation, not for, you know, farming, not for everything. Even schooling, you can take a park, a medicine, hospitals. Nothing. Simhapuri was then a wasteland. And of course, there we settled. And it still is, and of course it still is, but it is no longer empty. And of course it was, even though it was a wilderness, that means it was wilderness and wasteland, it still is, means it was having, that means it was, but it is no longer empty, means they were children, it was family members. How many families in structures of mud with the roofs of tin and tarpaulin, devoid of service, drainage, or running water, live 10,000 people, so 10,000 members were settled, and of course they squatted something. The squatters like, and of course they migrated from Dhaka to Delhi, periphery of Delhi, and known as Simhapuri. And Simhapuri was a wasteland. That means, you know, not for anything, not good for anything. But anyhow, they also settled there and started there. Started to get the survival. And of course, they have lived. So here you can see 10,000 Rarakpikos. They have lived here for more than 30 years, another 30 years. Yeah. So more than 30 years without an identity. You know, what does it mean? Identity means maybe the citizenship, of course. Without permits, but with the ration cards that get their names on voters. So they had that. And of course, unless and enable them to buy grains. That's all. That is their limitations. You have to remember that they have lived there, lived here for more than 30 years without an identity and without permits. Are without permits, but with ration cards, or get their names on voters list, and of course enable them to migrate. What is more important for survival than an identity? For them, whatever they want, they want the three times meal. That's all. So here, food is more important for survival than an identity. So if at the end of the day we can feed our families and go to bed without an aching stomach, it means, you know, pasiyulla or vayiru. That means that is known as aching stomach. Right, we would rather, and of course, live here than in the field that gave us no grain. So immediately, if it is not like that, then they have to settle. They have to migrate from that place and they have to settle in a different place. But somewhere, it was good. So if at the end of the day, we can feed our families and go to bed without an aching stomach, somewhere two meals, two times, and of course. Some satisfaction, some sort of sophistication, somewhere. Manageable. So here, go to bed without an aching stomach, and we would rather live here than in the fields that gave us no grind to something. So say a group of women in tattered sarees. What does it mean? Tattered sarees in the sense torn, you know, torn to pieces, something, kilinjibona, palaya, dirty, used. So here we are taking that, say a group of women in tattered sarees, when I ask them why they left their beautiful land of green fields and rivers. That's why they need the survival. When they are unable to get grains, they have to shift. This is what they are. So wherever they find food, they pitch their tents. That become transient homes. You know what is the meaning? Temporary homes. They can also fit, they can also sit anywhere, wherever they like. That's why here, they mentioned that they left their beautiful, and I'm sorry, whenever they find food, wherever. So wherever they find food, they pitch their tents that become transit homes. Children grow up in them, and of course they were also. This is what I already told you. You can also see street dwellers are because, and of course the children, they are playing, and of course in the dirty land, and of course near the ditch, and near the garbage, and of course near the drainage. But they will not, you know, go to hospital. They will not even take birth. But they are always, you know, happy looking at them. So children grow up in them, and of course becoming partners in survival. And survival in Simhapuri means that they have close to it. Okay? So yeah, children grow up in them, becoming partners in survival for your objective. MCQs. And survival in Simhapuri means rag picking. This is also different. What is the meaning of survival? Rag picking. Author of the narrator of the lesson, or you can check meaning or anything. Protagonist. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions, and I'm sorry, underline the proportions means maybe the forms, the parts, proportion of fine art, learning how to do that. It's like, you know, we are getting from our parents. So, and survival in Simhapuri means picking. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions of a fine art, proportion, underline it means forming or having the practice. Garbage to them is gold. You can also underline that. All the things are very important in the last paragraph, last few lines, and four to five lines. So garbage to them is gold. And it is the daily bread, which is garbage, is a daily bread. That means by that, by digging out the things, and of course they are selling, by that they are getting their daily bread. A roof over their heads means, even if it is a leaking, you know what is the meaning? Holes with, and of course, rope. But for a child, it is even more. You understand that? So nowadays we have sophisticated. Even we have, you know, some double story, triple, so we are taking that single story. We are taking constructed, very foundation one, and of course, cement and too many things we are mixing and building by using an engineer and by using a mason and of course assistant of masons and too many apprentices, too many workers. But building a house, just imagine that garbage to them is God. It is the day, it is their daily bread. A roof over their heads means even a transit home or even a very small, and of course even the mud, even the hive or whatever it is, roof over their heads, even if it is a leaking roof also. But for a child, it is even more in the sense for them that was very important. So I sometimes find a rupee, even a 10 rupee note also. Sahib says, besides lighting in the first year, we are taking lighting up. When you can find a silver coin in a heap of garbage, you don't stop scrounging. For this, for there is a hope of finding more. This is what he just shared with the narrator, right? So I sometimes, this is the name of the letter. So I sometimes find a rupee in the garbage, even a 10 rupee note. Sahib says, when you are sharing this, you can also see the narrator's image, and he's saying, and of course, here you can take Sahib Alam's image also with the back on the shoulder, and of course, back picking, and of course. So his eyes lighting up, he was very happy. That means, when whatever you receive, whatever you are, we are receiving, that means by receiving, we'll be happy, not giving and providing. The payment amount, வாங்குறதுலதான் சந்தோஷப்படும். நமக்கு தெரியும் ஒரு கிஃப்ட் கிடைக்குதுன்னா சந்தோஷம். சம்திங் ஃபார் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள், யூ ஆர் வாக்கிங் ஆன் த ஸ்ட்ரீட், ஸோ ஃபார்ச்சுனேட்லி யூ ஹவ் கம் அக்ராஸ் அ பண்டில் ஆஃப் யூனோ ருபீஸ் நோட், தட் மீன்ஸ் மேபி 2 lakhs, 1 lakhs ஆர் 10 lakhs, யூ வில் பி வெரி ஹாப்பி. ஆர் யூ வைல் யூ ஆர் வாக்கிங் ஆன் த ஸ்ட்ரீட், ஃபார்ச்சுனேட்லி யூ ஹவ் கம் அக்ராஸ் அ கோல்ட் செயின் தட் யூனோ இட்ஸ் லைக் 2 sovereigns, யூ வில் பி ஏன்னா ஹாப்பி. ஆர் வென் யூ ஆர் சீயிங் அ மொபைல் ஃபோன் ஆர் சம்திங் விச் இஸ் you know, very worthy enough, he will be very happy. For them, 10 rupee note was very worthy enough. That's why here, you know, when you can find a silver, so he was very lighting up, eyes lighting up, he became very happy. When you can find a silver coin in a heap of garbage, you don't stop crunching by the hope of fire. This is enough. When we find out something, we will also go for one step, another step to get some more. It seems that for children, garbage has meaning different from what it means to the parents, and of course, different situations. How the parents are taking, that means elders, and of course, the youngster, our children are taking. For children, it is wrapped. That's why, you know, for the children, it is wrapped in wonders. I mean, something is there beyond their even limitation and of course, expectations. For an example, used to things from a sophisticated families. There are toys. நிறைய கார் பொம்மை பொம்மைன்னு சொல்லுவோம்ல, நிறைய திங்ஸ், வாட் எவர் வீ கேன் டேக், ஈவன் தேர் யூஸ் ட்ரெஸ்ஸஸ் ஆர் வீ கேன் டேக் த பேக்ஸ், ஷூஸ், ஈவன் பெல்ட், ஈவன் மேக்கப் மெட்டீரியல்ஸ், காஸ்மெட்டிக் திங்ஸ் லைக் வாட் எவர் இட் இஸ் வீ டேக். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வை ஃபார் த சில்ட்ரன் இட் இஸ் ராப்ட் இன் வண்டர் சம்திங். ஃபார் த எல்டர்ஸ் இட் இஸ் மீன்ஸ் ஆஃப் சர்வைவிங். எல்டர்ஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் டிகிங் அவுட் ஆஃப் கெட்டிங் த திங்ஸ், அண்ட் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் பை செல்லிங் தட் தே ஆர் கிவிங் தேர் ஃபேமிலிஸ் மீன்ஸ். One winter morning, and of course, I see Sahib standing by a fenced gate of the neighborhood club watching. Two young men dressed in white playing tennis. I like the game in, you know, hums. And he mentioned, he says, content to watch it standing behind the fence. Fence means that particular gate. I go inside when no one is around. And he was also very happy when he was sharing with the narrator. He admits, it means the security. He admits the gatekeeper lets me use the swing. Swing, it is like a park, you know, what is the meaning in the park? Only sophisticated people, only the normal people will be allowed, or some payment we have to, some amount we have to pay to get the token or the ticket to get into the particular garden, or we can say the park. So that's why when they were playing, so one winter morning, I see Sahib standing by the fenced gate of the neighborhood club watching two young men dressed and in white and playing tennis. By looking at the dress code, he was, you know, surprised, and he was very happy. But when the narrator met and when she asked something, I like the game, he mentioned, he underlined, I like the game, he hums. Who was a speaker? He refers to, right? Who was answered? I like the game to the narrator. Sahib protagonist and the narrator, he hums, answers, replies, says, content means satisfied to watch it standing. It watched it in the sense that particular play, tennis. For him, that was something out of his reach. standing behind the fence to gate, and of course I go inside. He was also shy. I go inside when no one is around. He admits, underline the complete sentence for your MCQs, right? You can ask, I go inside where? You can also see, it means particular glove, right? I go inside when no one is around. He admits. And of course, the gatekeeper lets me use the swing. You know what is the meaning swing? Unjal. Unjal all the children, not only, you know, Sai, but also all the children will be very happy when they are using the swing. Sai too is wearing tennis shoes that look strange over this colored shirt and shorts. That means, you know, something he got it from somewhere. Someone gave them to me, he says, in a manner of explanation, when she was looking at that. The narrator, and another day when she met. The fact that they are discarded shows of some rich boy. Discarded means, you know, what does it mean, discarded? Something in a throne. Maybe, you know, given a power, we can take torn. Totally, you know, somewhere there was a hole or some damaged things like, that's why they just, you know, throw, okay? And of course, discarded shows of some rich boy, and of course, who perhaps refused to wear them because of a hole in one of them. But anyhow, refused to wear them because of a hole in one of them. Does not bother him means bother him, underline the word him and write sorry, because for him that was his, you know, something dream comes true like that. For one who has walked backward, even shows with the hole is a dream come true. But the game he is watching so intently is out of his reach. Mean anyhow, he also watched the shoes and the dress code of those rich are sophisticated, and of course the fellows those were playing. So anyhow, he also was given. He got discarded shoes with a hole in one of them. But he's watching so intently, the particular game is out of his reach. Nobody will allow to play, because for that we need a racket, and of course we need too many things to do with that. So this morning, and after another experience, you know, this morning, how if it's on, so it like, you know, we can take maybe a day's role. Too many days, and of course then our narrator got an opportunity to see him. And this morning, so if his son is waiting to the milk booth, something was different, right? So he was a rag picker, and he was a very energetic boy, and of course innocent and ignorant, and too many times the narrator met him and of course discussed too many things. But this morning he was so strange, looking so strange, because he carried something, a canister. So Saif is on his way to the milk booth in his hand, a steel canister. You know what is the meaning? Steel canister we are using for buying. And of course, you can also see milkmen, those who are coming to a village and of course visiting, and they are also and serving that, you know, milk. That is his profession, job. Steel canister. I now work in a tea stall down the road, he says, pointing in the distance. And of course, when the narrator was looking at him with too many questions, he understood, and of course he answered him. Now I know, you can underline this sentence. I now work in a tea stall down the road. And of course he says, who says? I refer to. Pointing in the distance. I am paid 800 rupees. That is very important. How much rupees? 800. You should not write 1,000, 3,000, 5,000, sometimes 50,000, 1,50,000. So you don't write. So you have to write, I am paid 800 rupees and all my meals. Does he like the job? Yes. That means, you know, to me, yes. Does he like? And of course, I see, and here while looking at here, does he like the job? I ask his face. I see has lost the carefree look. That means, you know, he was in a shop. And the steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry so lightly, because he was a rat picker since. So over his shoulder. This is what the narrator identified and understood, and of course justified, right? For the understanding of the reader, the bag was his. Very important. The bag was the sleeping. He was the owner. He can throw wherever he wants, right? But the canister he cannot, because the canister belongs. The canister simple present tense belonged to. Belonged to. Here you can take the steel canister belongs to the man who owns the tea shop. Simple present tense, owns, owner of the shop. Saif is no longer a scoutmaster. He no longer means that's all. You are no longer an admin. In the WhatsApp group, we have come across. Saif is no longer his own master means that's all. He lost everything. Now he is working in a tea shop, and of course, he has a boss And whatever the boss says, he has to follow. That means there is a schedule. That means 8 o'clock he has to reach, or 6 o'clock he has to reach, or 5 a.m. he has to reach the shop. He has to do all those activities, 8 hours or 9 hours or 12 hours. He has to go for 3 meals, everything. That's why he mentioned that. And of course, I am paid 800 rupees. And all my meals means 3 times, even tea included. All those things. This is what our first experience. That means, sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. So I want to drive a quad, we will discuss later.